I'm going to start off by adding a couple of objects. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under Mesh, I'm going to choose UV Sphere, then I'm going to right click it and choose Shade Smooth. Then I'm going to press Shift A again, and this time I'm just going to choose Cube. And I'm going to press S and then Y, which is going to scale my object across this Y axis. And I can just move my mouse to make this thinner. I'll left click about there for now. I'm then going to press G and then X just to pull this along. Now to set up our shader, let's first of all go into Material Preview. So I'm going to go into this Viewport Shading Material Preview, and right away you can see our objects are black. This is an issue that people can encounter in Blender 4.3 and 4.2, but thankfully to fix it, it's very simple for most users. All we need to do is come up to this Render Properties panel, change my render engine from Cycles to Eevee. I'm going to come to Ray Tracing, left click the box to enable it, left click this drop down. If you're in Blender 4.2, there'll be an option here called Max Roughness. Simply set that to 1 and the issue will be fixed. For Blender 4.3 users, come to Fast GI Approximation and change your threshold to 1. Now that's fixed the issue. If your material is still black, it might be that your computer is incompatible with the new Eevee changes in Blender 4.2 and 4.3, in which case I would recommend using a previous version like Blender 4.1, which is still a great version of Blender. And you'll still be able to follow along with this tutorial. You'll just have to skip the last step. Now let's go ahead and add a basic material. So I'll left click my ball here, and I'm going to change from the timeline here to the shader editor, and I'm going to left click and drag this menu to pull it up. I'll then change from line style here to object, which allows us to then add materials to our selected objects, and I'm going to press plus new. You have a couple of options here. You could go ahead and make a procedural brick material, but for us today, we're just going to be using some textures. But where can we get these textures? Thankfully, there's plenty of free options. On my web browser here, I'm just going to come to a website called polyhaven.com. This is a great website for getting free PBR textures. They also have stuff like HDRIs and 3D models as well. If you're looking for other sources of PBR textures, you can have a look on CG Bootcase as well, which is another resource I like to use. And it's also a free one as well. Under textures, I'm just going to go ahead and left click browse textures. And right at the top, you can see we have a few options we can filter by. I'm just going to go ahead and left click brick. You can see we have quite a few awesome options here. I'm going to go ahead and choose this brick wall 006 down here. So I'll just left click it, and I'm just going to keep it at the default so you can see I've got it set to 4K and I've got it on as a zip, and I can go ahead and just choose download. Also, if you want to download a lower resolution version, you can choose the 1K or 2K here, or if you want higher resolution, you can choose 8K. Just keep in mind, the higher resolution you have, the longer your render times will be. So for this video, I'm just going to stick with 4K. Once your download is finished, you can go ahead and just close your browser. Next up, I'm just going to come to my downloads folder in my file browser, and I'm going to left click this brick wall 006, and I'm just going to left click this extract all button, and I'm just going to extract it into my downloads folder. But you can choose a specific location on your computer to keep things nice and organized. Once the extraction is complete, we will have a brick wall 006 regular folder here, which if I double click to open it and then double click textures, we'll have all of our textures in here. I'm going to change my view here to extra large icons just to show you some of these textures. You can see we've got ambient occlusion, displacement, diffusion, and this one here. We also have some roughness ones and normal, which we can't actually see just now as they are labeled as EXR images, but we will be able to use them inside a Blender. You also see that there's a NORGL, which stands for Normal Map GL, and a NORDX, which stands for Normal DX. We're going to want to use the Normal GL because Blender works in OpenGL instead of DirectX. For now, I'm just going to close my file browser, and I'm going to come back to Blender here. I'm then going to press Shift and then A, and then under Texture, I'm going to choose Image Texture. This node here allows us to add an image from our computer into Blender. So I'm going to press Open, and then I'm going to come to my downloads here, and find my brick wall 006 and double click it to open. I'll then double click textures again. Now you can see we can see all of our different textures. I'm just going to choose the brick wall diffuse, and diff or diffuse just stands for base color pretty much. So I'll just plug my color into the base color. And there, now it's gone ahead and added our texture. Let's go ahead and name our material. So I'm going to left click material and call it brick. Then I'm going to left click my second object here, left click the drop down, and choose brick for this one as well. This one isn't unwrapped properly, but there's a great simple unwrap we can do. First of all, since we scaled this in object mode, we will need to apply the scale first. If you don't know what applying the scale is, I did make a video on it, which I'd highly recommend checking out if you're a beginner. I'm going to left click my object, press Ctrl and then A to open the apply menu, and then choose scale. This then sets the scale of this object to 1 on all axes, which means when we unwrap it, it's going to unwrap it with the faces being the correct size. I'm then going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode, press A to select all faces, then I can press U to open the Unwrap menu, then under Unwrap, I'm going to choose Cube Projection. You can see straight away, that's looking a lot better. We may want to adjust things for the sphere and the wall later, but I'll show you how to do that in a bit. For For now, let's go ahead and make sure we're using the right vector coordinates. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under Input, I'm going to choose Texture Coordinate. Then, since we've UV unwrapped these, and this sphere here is using its default UV, which is actually quite good for square-based textures, I'm going to plug my UV into the vector. You'll see no change, as textures use the UV coordinates by default, but I thought I would add the texture coordinate and explain, just to build your understanding of how these nodes work. Next up, let's go ahead and add the next PBR texture for roughness. The reason they're called PBR textures in the first place is because we're using multiple images to influence multiple parameters to create a more realistic result. And what PBR stands for is just physical based rendering. As of course, a real life material isn't just going to have a base color, it's also going to have reflections and other things influencing it. Let's go ahead and add the roughness. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under texture, I'll choose image texture again. I'll press open. I'll come to my downloads and go into Brickwall 006. Then inside of textures, I'm just going to choose Brickwall 006 rough. If your material doesn't have roughness, it might have something called gloss instead. If so, just left click that and then press open image. For us, we're just going to use roughness. Then I'll plug my UV into the vector and I'm going to change my color space here from linear to non-color. Then I'm going to plug my color into the roughness. Now our brick will have realistic reflections in terms of reflection clarity. However, there's another type of roughness we're going to be adding later, which is new to Blender 4.3 and will allow us to get some extra realism for brick materials, concrete materials, and other rough non-metal materials like that. Finally though, let's go ahead and add the normal to add a little bit of depth to our textures. I'll press Shift A and then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture. Then I'm going to left click open and then inside of downloads, I'm going to come to Brickwall 006, textures, and this time I'm going to choose the normal GL as I mentioned earlier. This is the one we want to use, not the direct X one. So I'll press NOR GL and then press open image. Then I'm going to change my color space to non-color and I'm going to plug my vector into the UV. Then we can't just plug our color straight into the normal, we have to give it a node to go through. So I'm going to press Shift A, and then under vector, I'm going to choose normal map, and I'll plug my color into the color of this. Then I can plug my normal into the normal, and now we'll get some simulated depth. Straight away, you can see this is looking a lot more 3D, and it actually looks pretty cool. Of course though, if you want to make it a little bit more 3D, you can use the displace texture as well, either with the bump node or the displacement node. If you want to learn how to use those nodes, I do have a video on it here, which you can check out. For us though, we're just going to leave it there. One thing I did want to mention though, is that if you're using different textures from me and you got a gloss instead of a roughness, you will need to add an extra step. You'll need to press Shift A and then in the search bar, you can just search for invert. Then you can take this invert color and plug it in between the roughness and the color. You can see after I've done that, it's made my material really reflective and watery looking. And that's because we've actually inverted the reflections to make them a lot more reflective. Since our reflections were right, since we were using roughness, we don't actually need this though. So we can either turn this to zero by left clicking the one and changing it to zero to set it back to normal, or we can press Ctrl X with it selected to dissolve it, meaning we don't have to disconnect our chain and add it again. For now though, let's talk about how we can adjust our brick texture on our different objects. We're going to have a slightly different adjustment for each object. So the first thing I'm going to do is left click my wall here, and I'm going to left click this new material button, which is actually just going to duplicate it. So I'll left click that, and you'll see now it's called brick.001, whereas when I left click the sphere, we've just got the normal brick. Let's start with this one. First of all, I'm going to press Shift A, and then I'm going to search for mapping. Mapping allows us to adjust the coordinates going in, meaning we can affect how our textures look using a node instead of our UVs. So I'm just going to plug my UV into the vector, and then I'm going to go ahead and plug this vector into all of these vector sockets here. Once we're done, it should look something like this. Nothing will change because we haven't actually changed any of these parameters yet. The main one I like to change for this UV sphere, as it tends to make things a bit stretched, is the Y scale. So I'm going to change that to 0.5. And you can see straight away, it's made our bricks a little bit more proportionally correct. Of course though, you can do loads of things. Like for example, if you wanted your bricks to be a little bit thinner, you could put it back to 1, or maybe you could go in between for 0.75. So you can get a lot of control with this awesome node. You can also do rotation and location as well. For our brick wall here, I'm fairly happy with how this is looking, so I'm going to leave it as how it is. But if you do want to make your object itself a little bit better, we can come to this modifier properties here, press add modifier, and under generate, I'll just choose bevel, and I'll maybe make this bevel a little bit smaller to something like that, and increase the segments to something like 3, giving it more of a smoother appearance. But there's still one more thing we can do to make our brick materials a little bit more realistic, and that's we can come to this diffuse parameter on our principal BSDF and change our roughness to 1. What this does is it changes between two different reflection models for non-metals. When it's set to 0, it's using something called a Lambertian reflection, which is a very simple type of reflection, which I find tends to work great for more smoother, reflective surfaces. Before your rougher surfaces like brick and concrete that are non-metal, setting this to 1 will use the Oren-Nayer BSDF instead. BSDF just means a bidirectional scattering distribution function, so what I mean by that it's just enabling a new function. So you don't need to think of it as anything more complex than that. But when that function is enabled, it's going to use a much more sophisticated form of rendering calculation, which works great for these rougher materials, giving them a more realistic appearance. This is brand new in Blender 4.3, so if you don't see this option, you just need to update to the newest version. Right now, we can't really see a difference, and that's because we actually need to go into Cycles first to see it. To do that, all we need to do is set up an HDRI and go into Cycles. So first of all, I'm going to come to my render properties, and change my render engine to Cycles. Even though those ray tracing settings to affect the material displaying as black were done in Eevee, they will be saved when we change to Cycles, so you don't need to worry about those disappearing. Then I'm going to come to my world properties here, and I'm going to press plus new to add a new world. You might already have one already. Then under color, I'm going to left click the yellow dot and change it to environment texture. If I go into my render preview just now to go into Cycles, right now it's just going to make everything purple, which just indicates there's a missing texture. And when I press this open button here, it's just going to allow us to choose an image on our computer. But first, we'll need to actually download an HDRI. So I'm going to come back to polyhaven.com again, and this time, instead of going browse textures, I'm going to choose browse HDRIs. HDRIs are just images which you can use to light up your scene realistically, very quickly. These are great, especially for quickly previewing new materials you're making, but they can also be used in some projects as well. I'm going to left click the indoor section here, and I'm going to choose this Brown Photo Studio 2, which is my favorite HDRI on the site. Again, all of these are free, which is awesome, and they're CCO, meaning you can use them in your projects. I'm going to leave these settings at the default, so 4K EXR, and then I can go ahead and press download, but since I've already downloaded this, I'm just going to leave it. Once your download is finished, you can go ahead and just close your browser. Back in Blender now, I can go ahead and left click this open button, then I can just come to the downloads folder in my file browser, and in the search bar, I can just search for EXR to filter by these EXR images. Here I've got this Brown Photo Studio EXR HDRI, and I'm just going to left click that and press open image. And now we can see our brick in its full glory. Also, if you turn off the show overlays, we can see it a little bit clearer. And yeah, that pretty much covers it. Well done on creating some quick realistic brick. If you want to learn more about making materials in Blender, make sure to check out my playlist here to learn some more and take your material knowledge to the next level. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.